Ray Give TV exclusive.
Yo, Ping Ray in here, bro.
He just popped in.
There it go. Somebody must have told him.
It's Ray Give TV.
Back with some more heat. Oh, you didn't know? I got the content. Click that bell, tune in. Okay, so check it out. WAC 100 reacts to Bosco, clout chasing yet again, and flames him for taking a stand at 12 years old. What? I'm going to give a shout out to WAC 100, the whole 100 side spin the block. Let's get to the content.
It's Ray Give TV.
Spin the block.
You big dummy. These niggas did bozoed you, nigga. They did fed you some fake shit. You just caught a stray bullet for no reason. No reason.
And how he got his fucking nerve to call somebody a snitch and he's on fucking tape. 4-year-old snitching little bitch. Your mama told you, nigga. She ain't gonna lie on you.
Nigga, that nigga didn't fight that one bit.
Cause he know that shit true. It's hard to fight the truth. Damn, that's fucked up. So what bias people at? Y'all don't think that's telling? At 12 years old? Nah, they
gonna fuck with him. They say he good still, I guess. That, you know, a guap. They'll still be like, oh, he good though. He, if that was whack though, let's do the old reversal. If that was whack, can having a field day.
That's real.
They be having a field.
I mean, now that's selective politicking right there. If they don't see what's going on or what went on.
Yeah, but that's what they do when it comes to whack. It's always some selective shit.
Yeah.
They gonna learn their lesson.
Hell nah, Guap. That's telling like.
Man, nigga, I wouldn't give a f- how old you is, bro. If you was 6 years old and you got on the stand and told some shit, nigga, you a rat.
Damn, a 6-year-old?
Man, I wouldn't give a fuck, bro. If you got on the stage and you told, that's what you gonna do all your life.
Hell yeah, you just can't be a gangster. I'm sorry.
I feel that. I ain't gonna lie, I feel that.
Nah, parents gotta make sure that children don't be put in that type of
bro,
situation.
That nigga was 12 years old. Out here now. Okay, let's spice it up. Hey, I'm from the Valley. I'm a 12-year-old from the Valley. So that means, you know, you from where you from. You from inner city, as you say. You should be way more than enhanced and advanced than my 12, right? We both gangbanging. We both going to juvenile hall. Only whack ain't taking no stand testify, nigga. That's out, nigga. I watch the blow his brains out in front of me. 11. I didn't even get him a statement. I wasn't even around for them to talk to me. Ain't happening. Not happening, boy. Put a murder on me at 13, 14. Put a body on me. Wasn't mine. They arrest 3 adults. I'm already in jail for attempted murder already on one nigga, Baby Turtle from East Coast. I'm already in there for a 664. They gonna kick the doors and all them niggas. They figure, fuck it, we gonna arrest these niggas. Hold him. We're going to go back to juvenile hall, book the nigga whack for the murder. He already got attempted murder. He going to break. Called me down there. Said, yeah, you know, you got another charge. Want to know what it is? Murder. Got anything I to say about it? Hey, bro, can y'all wait to update my charges? Because they watch this tonight. It's movie night, bro. I want to see this movie they bringing in, bro. They just like, you know. School days or something. Can y'all wait? Because if y'all update, they gonna move me back to L&M. What are you talking about? You say you adding the murder to my attempted murder, right? We're not enhancing the attempted murder. This is a new card murder. Okay, cool. They gotta take me back to L&M to rebook me. Now I got a plug down there, but he don't go to work. At least do it tomorrow. Tomorrow I can get back up because I want to watch the movie tonight, bro. Do all your booking.
I'm LP.
Hey, listen, them niggas bad as a motherfucker. They said, all of them said you did it. I said, I don't even know who all of them is and nothing you did. Bro, they got popcorn, everything, nigga. I'm trying to get back to the unit. You done talking? Do you know what this means? Well, what mean? Motherfucker, the movie gonna come on in 20 minutes. Do you know what that mean? That motherfucker was looking at me.
They was trying to get.
They don't know about them movie nights, whack. Movie nights is different.
Yo, they let everybody else go for the county jail and left me with the body that I wasn't even around to do. I fought that shit 6-7 months of juvenile hall, beat the shit. Motherfucker witness come in and said, can you give us a description of the night? They said, yup. About 10:30, the shooter was sitting on the passenger side windowsill, aiming back towards the sidewalk, towards the driver's side, and it was raining with the shots. What did he have on? He had on the hoodie. It was kind of dark. It was fairly dark. Okay. He said, so dark, gunshots that far away, you can identify the defendant? The witness said, no, I didn't see it was him, but he always come over there putting in work. It had to be him. Nigga, you should have seen the look on the judge's face. What the fuck did you just say? My attorney said, let me get this right. You didn't see it was him. Nah, man, they was shooting. I ain't had time to be looking at where they was shooting. We was running. He said, but you saw the victim get shot. Yeah, we saw him get shot. He took the first three. Then dude just starts praying. And you're saying it's my client. Why? He comes over there every day putting in work. He comes over there every day. Every day. So you're saying it's him because he comes over here every day. It had to be him this night. Yes. Your Honor, we like to move for dismissal.
Hell yeah. He just said he ain't see shit, baby. He see nothing.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, I had to sit in the box for a minute, but I just accepted the fact, worst come to worst, I'm just going to do juvenile life. Fuck it. I'm finna walk all 12. I'll be on when I'm 25. That's it. At that age, they couldn't do nothing but give me juvenile life. They couldn't. Yep. They couldn't charge me as a dote or nothing. So, I mean, I know what come with this shit. You know, that wasn't my case, but it's what it is. Fuck.
That's how that shit Wack, goes. Do you ever, if you would have got juvenile life, you would have probably still been doing, or you think you would have, because that's a whole different, was different than getting to the pen. I think you, my personal opinion, I think
it
you
would have been a different member. I came home at 22. So, I'd have lost them years that I was doing whatever I was doing. You know, I don't know where it would have led me. You know, I came home at 22 out the pen. Then I'd have did another 3 and some change. So I don't know where it would have landed me. You know what I'm saying? But you know what? I ain't lying. I think me, I'd end up in the pen anyway. I probably would have caught a case.
Think it too whack. That's how
which would have forced the juvenile life anyway, and then whatever case I would have caught, it would have been consecutive to the age of 25. So if I'd have caught a sticking or assault that got me like another 3 to 5 or something, then it made me deal till I was 25, then I'd have started doing that time. But they would have definitely changed my housing. For sure.
So that was a bonus, them giving you that deal going to the pen, I think. That was love.
For real, it all worked out.
It worked out,
You know, like I tell motherfuckers, bro, it's ups and downs, bro. I ain't really never seen nobody who just had all ups. You know, it's ups and downs, bro. You just got to ride that fucking way, ride that horse, bro. Stay on that motherfucking roller coaster, bro. Stay in the race. Don't check out the race. Once you check out the race at the sideline, you know where you're going, right where you at. Stay in that motherfucking race, bro. Stay in the race. You never know what it's going to bring you, bro. Sometimes you're in survival mode, what I got to do to survive today, whatever. And as long as you can make a move and talk to people and do something and figure something out, you still in the game, bro. You still in the game.
Drop a comment down below. Let me know what y'all think about the content. Bosco 100, told on a body back in the day. What were we giving? Let's get back to it.
You still in the game.
How do you mentally prepare yourself to be in jail for a long amount of time? Because I'm not mentally strong enough. I feel like I would
Well, you got to remember, you 24, 25 right now. Yeah. So, okay, if you go look at that shit I put up on my IG, I'm born in 77. That's 1989. I'm 12. So I remember my first day in jail at 12, right? It was torture. You like can't walk out this motherfucker. You like, nigga, I'm really in this motherfucker. So every day is just like anything else. You ever pay attention to these animals on how they know how to do certain shit?
Yeah.
Right? How they train a dog to go over here and open the door and this. Mm-hmm. Anything that you are doing over and over and over again,
your mind
conditions yourself to it.
Muscle memory.
You know what I'm saying? So with you, it's different because you've been free. With me, motherfucker, I hadn't experienced as much freedom as you've experienced, right? At 24 when I was 12.
Right. Yeah, right.
And then, in my mind, I'm conditioned to this is what come with it. I hate to say it. Back then, we like, oh, yeah, nigga, I just got a stripe. I can't wait to get out. Mm-hmm. It's really. Back then, it was kind of like, you know, a badge of honor.
It was college.
Yeah. It was a badge of honor. You needed to go to jail, put that work in there to add that to your portfolio. So when now it was like, the homie didn't did some time, nigga. What they caught him on that thing, he stayed solid, didn't tell him, took the case. He was up in that motherfucker putting in work, you know what I'm saying? And then, you know, over the years, when that's all you chasing, that's all you know, that's what you become. It's just like you going to work every day. You're like, okay, I'm this. I want to be the supervisor. Then I want to be the GM. Then I want to be over this region. How do you go to... You have some niggas that sell dope or do illegal shit and say, how do they go to work every day that long, nigga? How much they trying to make? Oh, man, that's $150,000 a year.
Yeah.
$150,000 a year. That's $12,000 a month. Nigga, we doing that a day, right? But they mind ain't conditioned to it the way yours is. You know what I'm saying? So that's what it is. I was really conditioned because I was young. And it doesn't dawn on me. Like, I come around R&B, right? And when I look at, you know, my children now, I'm like, one of the boys is 16. Nigga, I was in the penitentiary.
At that age.
And I'll be like, God damn, nigga, I was in the penitentiary. At his age, you know what I'm saying? I'm sitting there
like.
Yeah,
my mom the same way, yeah.
Yeah, I'm like, damn. But, you know, y'all different. Youth is different now. You know, we was more hands-on, outside, figure shit out. And, you know, it was a little different, a little more crazier. I'm glad the laws wasn't as bad as they are today. You know, I be seeing some of my homies that do shit that I might have caught 5 years on, 4 years on. Man, they giving these niggas 50 years. My little nigga, 19, 20, 59 years. The fuck? You know what I'm saying?
Like, no parole. Stretching. Nothing.
For an attempt.
I'll never forget when you said that shit when you was in your cell. It was 7 steps literally to the gate and back to bed.
Yeah, they got it. Okay, shit. So look, when you coming into the shit, when you coming into the cell, right? When you walk in, right? As soon as you walk in, the door closes. If you reach your arm out to the left, you got a locker on the wall, and it's a locker up underneath it. Right, if you reach your arm down to the right, it's the sink and the toilet connected. You take one step, the bunk beds are to the right. You take 6 more steps, you run into the table where people can sit and write their letters. You can't go no farther than the table. Half an arm's length is the wall and a little window that's usually tinted. You can't see shit. So if you turn around 7 steps back, you're back at the door. It may be 2 steps between the bed and the locker in between. That's it.
And that's what I'm saying. How do y'all mentally prepare yourself to do
this? Oh, no, we got everything in there. We got a motherfucker's burners. To cook shit work better than your shit at the house. You know what I'm saying? Bottom bunk bed. We roll that bitch back, clean that motherfucker up. We set our little bombs up underneath the motherfucker, light them up. We cook our motherfucking, all the meat, whatever the fuck we didn't got from the kitchen and shit. I hook up back there. We cook all that right there. We make about 10 different dishes. We got our color TVs in there. You know what I'm saying? The motherfucking toilet area, that's the cleanest area in the United States of America. You know what I'm saying? We got unlimited. We got bleach, the little motherfucking, the little chemical balls is probably too strong for us to be using. We dropping them. She, look, ain't no spitting in the sink. You got to spit in the toilet. That's it. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no, nigga, you flush while you use the bathroom.
Courtesy flush.
We got our own makeshift little curtain go by there. You know what I'm saying? Me, because I was a short nigga, I preferred the top bunk. Everybody knew. Going to sell with Wack, he got all the TVs, and you're going to get the bottom bunk. That was the thing. Whoever's in the bottom bunk, you was in the cell longer. Now, my thing is security. You got to reach down. That's more access to me. So I got it. Well, you got to reach up playing with me in case I'm up there sleep. Other than that,
now,
you know,
what jails allow you to have phones and shit? Because I've been seeing inmates going live on TikTok and shit like that.
No, there ain't no, there no jails allow you to have no damn phone.
They be going live on TikTok.
I don't know if they can do no. They got iPads now, but they block some of the apps. I don't think they give them Instagram and TikTok.
No, you can't get none of that
shit. I literally was just on TikTok and
but niggas got phones. Phones can range from 1,000 to 2,000-3,000, depending on what prison's at. The further north your prison are, you at, the more that phone gonna call. The higher security that prison is, the more the phone gonna call.
Cuz those shit was $2,500.
There you go. Where he at? Where he at?
Michigan.
Yeah, probably up north. $2,500
for that motherfuckers. Yeah.
I said $1,000. You gotta think about the correctional officers. Even if they go get the phone for $500, they made a $2,000 profit. Every five is 10. Look at what they sell. They making most selling phones, and they making on their salary.
Mm.
And then what they go do, they go raid them every 90 days, collect them all back so they can go re-up and get the money again.
Get it again, right. Damn, that's cold-blooded than a motherfucker.
Hey, don't be teaching Tink that shit, bro. You know she about to be a correctional officer.
If Tink becomes a correctional officer, Tink is going to get fucked.
On fire.
Every day.
Tink, somebody go, look, I'm going to be real. Hey, look, bro, I'm going to ask Khan. Somebody is going to, Tink's going to hook up with a parolee. I'm telling you, I know a personality and mentality. Yo, it's some real niggas in there. It's some real smart niggas. Niggas got their health going right, their body right. They smart, they get money niggas. I didn't watch niggas buy houses from the penitentiary. And you got to remember, Tink has understanding of us. Straight up.
She gonna be hard to get over on if she did do that shit. I was trolling her. I was trolling her, but if she did do that shit.
They gonna be on you, I'm gonna be telling you. They gonna be, hey, listen.
I just, I'm gonna be the desk guard, though.
They gonna be drawing down on you, Tink.
Oh, you gonna do that shit for real? I was trolling.
Tink going there with them titties. Tink going there with them titties. They gonna be in the shower jacking off for you, putting on the show for you, boy.
Hey, when she do her little walkthrough, count time. They soon count over.
Soon as you lock eyes with one and you don't tell.
I ain't trying to do the overnight shit.
Soon as you lock eyes with one and you don't tell. Oh yeah, he in love. He gonna be ready to stab a nigga over you.
He told the truth though.
Hell yeah. Listen. A nigga be the get big with me. He gonna get to hollering at you. Yo, you got a P.O. box. What you doing out there? How you living? Looking? What you get a crib? What's up with your credit? I get it right. They gonna have plugs for everything. They gonna get to send the money out to that motherfucker. That nigga, you gonna know that nigga 18 months to the house. You gonna take your motherfucking vacation time, boy, right when he getting out. I'm telling you.
Yeah, I shall be watching that show.
Watch this nigga, peek at this nigga, and you go. Women, it ain't no different than men. Nigga, we walking through there, she playing with her pussy, we'll be coming through. A lot of us ain't gonna tell. Damn, this bitch is bad as a motherfucker. Okay. Ain't gonna say nothing. You know I get out in 6 months. Oh, okay. You know what I'm saying? It's real shit. Some motherfuckers ain't got nothing to go back to.
Literally, because they, type. You know, they do, these females, now the trend is, they get on, like, this website called, like, Pen Pal or some shit like that. I forget what it's called. They get on there, and they get them men from jail type shit. Like, people get married off of that shit now.
That's how the girl...
Wow. Bosco 100. What you guys think about the whole situation? Drop a comment down below. Let me know. I appreciate the support. Everybody tuning in, man. My message to the people. Keep your best foot forward. Make the most of your 24 hours. Stay down until you come up. You got to stay on the grind. Apply yourself. Be proactive. Ain't nobody going to hand you nothing. You don't have to get up and go earn that. For real. And why wait for anybody anyway when you can go get it yourself? Time waits for no man. Ain't no lacking, ain't no slacking, ain't no half-stepping out here. You feel me? You gotta put some hustle behind that muscle and get to it. It will be greater later. Like I always say, man, you just have to stay down until you come up. You know what I mean? This is a marathon. You feel me? You don't have to keep it pushing. You know? Shout out to the people, man. Please be sure to keep that notification bell turned on at all times. Like the video, share the video, subscribe if you haven't. I will be coming with some more heat soon, so stay tuned. But until next time, it's your boy Ray Gibb, and I'm gone. God bless. Peace. Thanks for watching another reaction video.